Hey, Shalom, Shalom.
Shalom.
Hey, first and foremost, we'll give all praises, honor, and glory to the Heavenly Father and Son, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakakodash. Double honors to the apostles, the elders, the GMS, who rule well. Peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. Hey, this is Preacher Cal from GMS Stop and Listen. I'm on location in Dallas, Texas. I'm here with the brother Preacher R.
Shalom.
Hey, man, we just sitting here rapping about this end day, man, the day of the Lord. What you read in Zephaniah, man, because the day of the Lord is coming soon, and it's going to be a big power shift with the Lord bringing the nation of Israel back and putting them in the that rulership, that position of that dominion to be given to them, the position of rulership, the kingdomship going to be given to us, and Esau is going to be put in subjection, man.
Mm-hmm.
This is Zephaniah 1:14, the great day of the Lord Yahweh is near. It is near, right? And hasteneth greatly, even the voice of the day of the Lord Yahweh, the mighty men shall cry there bitterly, man. And those mighty men are those elite men of this society, man. They're going to cry bitterly because when the Lord is his great day, he's going to basically knock your power structure down. He's going to destroy everything that you have been creating since 1350, since the Renaissance, man. Your time of rulership is over. It's over, man. This is your heaven, and you're ruling it backwards right now.
That's right.
And it's your last time, man, because the Lord is about to set the rightful rulership up, man.
That's right. If I may, you even had an example within a few days ago with George H.W. Bush, man, just croaked. Even though we understand he was 94, he was older. Yeah, we get it. But we still look at that as a spiritual indicator to show you, because he was a president.
And yeah, 41st president of the United States.
And he was a huge demon at that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he was a member of, he was a known, notorious member in Skull and Bones. He had the famous speech going into the New World Order. And we all remember that. You know, so with him croaking just a few days ago, that's a key indicator, indicator. Which shows us that America's power structure is getting ready to fall soon. And you'll have certain people that look at it. Oh, he was old anyway. No, man, we get it, but we look past that. You know what I'm saying? He could have died at any time. The Lord made him live till 94.
Amen.
Just to fall at this time where all these great things are happening in history.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so these are things we have to note through the Spirit. And as this priest is going into, man, this is a time that we look at and observe, and it shows us that we're at the very end, because those rulers are coming down.
They're coming down, man. Hey, it's symbolic, too. Through the Spirit, the Lord had me do a video probably about a month ago on those two eagles that had to be rescued in Alabama.
Mm.
Like, how did two eagles just fall out of the sky? You know, they were both on the ground in that water together, which they look like a two-headed eagle, which goes into Janus, that witchcraft, that double-headed eagle, man. So, damn, they say like they telling us. They talking to us. Oh, really?
It's cool. Oh, hey, that's even if they not, the spirit is spirit.
Somebody's like, fuck yeah. Hey, Aki, man, we getting it in, man. People don't like it. It says, verse 15, the day is a day of wrath. A day of trouble and distress, man. A day of wrath and trouble, man.
Mm-hmm.
Because all hell is about to break loose, man. Lord is about to unleash famines, more pestilence. He's about to put the spirit on Esau. He's about to be that old ancient Roman spirit. Mm-hmm. He's going to bring martial law. Jacob's trouble is right around the corner, man.
That's right.
And if you're not part of that elect, hey, man, you're not going to be saved, man.
That's right.
You know, and it says, a day of wasteness and desolation, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and thick darkness, man.
Whew. Right.
And that's like thick darkness, man. When it's thick darkness, you can't see none. It's all obscurity, man.
Mm-hmm.
And that day is going to be one dilemma after another, like when you read in Amos, the fifth chapter. Like you're going to be running from a lion and a bear going to meet you. You're going to escape the bear and get bit by a serpent. Many dilemmas are going to be going on in that day. If you don't have the spirit of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai.
Bro. Hey, there's a movie. Stephen King. I'm going to say it's a novel. It started off as a novel. Stephen King, The Mist, right?
The Mist.
You've heard about it. And there was a movie that came out about 10 years ago. And then there was a series on Netflix called The Mist, which is based off of that novel.
Mm-hmm.
But it goes into there's a cloud that pretty much invades the city. Mm-hmm. And if you're outside, if you're not inside of your house, and if you enter in, or if that cloud gets through mm-hmm. cracks and crevices, it goes into your house, you imagine all of your worst fears and your worst terrors and monsters and whatever it is, it's presented in front of you.
The king of terror.
The king of terrors. So just thinking about that show, you see where they got the idea and just going into this lesson that this brother's going into, man. The Lord is going to present us with terrible fears that we didn't even know existed in front of us. So that we've seen on movies. And we see there are certain movies that come out, House on the Haunted, it was called The Cabin in the Woods. You know, where they showed all that type of stuff, man. It's going to be a day that these people are really going to dread, and you're really going to have you're really going to have your doorposts and your lintel covered in the blood of Yahawashi, your mind, your mind covered with his blood in order to go through this and be good, man. You know, that's the only, and that's synonymous, I should say first. That's synonymous for this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. And that's the only thing that's going to be able to cover us within this evil time that's to come.
Man, that was a beautiful point you just made, and I'm going to back you up right quick. This is Ezekiel 9:4. It says, "And the Lord Yahweh said unto him, Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof." You know, so it's that exemption. That mark is that exemption from judgment. That's like you said, the brother just made a good point, man. If you don't have your that blood on your doorpost, then the angels are not gonna they're not gonna pass over you. You know,
that's right.
We're coming into a great Passover, and if it's coming, it's gonna be that Passover. It's gonna be greater than the Passover that was in Egypt, man.
Right?
You know,
that's right.
This is one that's not gonna be forgotten. The destruction of America, man.
That's right, Khan, brother.
You know. This is Zephaniah 1, and I think we were at 16. A day of the trumpet and alarm against the fenced cities and against the high towers, man. So that day is coming against America, man.
That's right.
We're blowing the trumpet right now with the words of the Heavenly Father. Soon we're going to hear that great sound from heaven, man. And these heavens are going to open up, and Yahweh Shai and his angels are going to appear.
That's right.
And they're going to appear to wreak havoc. Destruction, bring desolation, and save the elect, man.
That's right. That's right. They're going to bring that fiery sword upon Babylon, man. You know, that's those angels are prepared for war. And us being angels, too, we're blowing that trumpet. And what's going to follow afterward is those actual angels, those seven angels blowing that trumpet. And that's going to send forth fire down here to this wicked place.
It says, verse 17, "I will bring distress upon men, that they shall walk like blind men." When you walking blind, you're groping. You see nothing. You're feeling around. Like I said, darkness is obscurity, man. It's terror. It's scary to be in a dark place and not know your next step.
Exactly.
Whether you're going to fall off a cliff or whatever, or fall in a hole, you know. It's that's hey, man, that's a terrible place to be. That's going to be here in America, man.
That's right.
And it says, "Because they have sinned against the Lord Yahweh, and their blood shall be poured out as dust, and their flesh also as dung." So, man, Yahweh Bashim Yahushai is coming back to kill you people, man. The people who have sinned against his law and his statutes and commandments and have not had faith. If you're not part of the elect, he says 2/3 of my people are going to be cut off and die. Zechariah, man.
That's right.
And that's real heavy. Because that's 66% of all the Israelites across the whole world. That's a lot of deaths, a lot of people. And the Lord is getting ready to bring it, man. If you got a closing scripture.
I do. This is Nahum, the third chapter. I'm going to start at the 17th verse.
Nahum?
Yeah, come.
Third chapter?
3:17, come.
Okay, go ahead.
It says, "Thy crowned are as locusts, and thy captains as the great grasshoppers, which camp in the hedges in the cold day." So he's going in, when you read it in Nahum, he's condemning or prophesying against the kingdom of Nineveh, which was a chief city in Assyria during the Assyrian Empire, which is synonymous. We use this scripture going into the judgment of America. Now, it said, because as the starting scripture, as you went into, talked about thy mighty men shall cry bitterly, loosely paraphrasing, but it says thy crown, which represent kings and rulers, are as locusts, and thy captains, mighty men, kings, lower level kings,
anointed ones.
That's right.
It's grasshoppers. Ones.
And it says, which camp. And when you're camping, that means you're in a lodging place. Okay, chilling. You know? which camped in the hedges in the cold day. Mm. Now, when you think of the cold day, that brings us back to Genesis 3rd chapter, when Adam and Eve were pretty much made, and when they realized they was naked, it said they wandered around among the trees in the cool of day, mm-hmm. which goes into a period right before judgment happens.
Yeah.
The calm before the storm, mm-hmm. when you're chilling in your crib
before
and that
night.
Thief yeah. comes to you, what you least expecting.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this is going into.
Okay.
Okay. So as we continue, it says, but when the sun ariseth, they flee away. When the sun ariseth.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we can go to plenty of scripts. How Yahweh Shai represents, he's the morning star.
Come.
And you read in Revelation 21.
22nd chapter.
That's right. In Malachi.
Offspring and root of David.
That's right.
Come.
In Malachi, the 4th chapter, talks about when the sun of righteousness ariseth.
Mm-hmm.
So we can
and,
see.
And put us in healing in his wings.
That's
You're
right.
Healing,
healing
yeah,
in his wings.
Come.
But
come.
The wicked ain't going to look at it such.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they understand looking at that. That's synonymous for their destruction.
Mm-hmm.
So we talk about the crown, locusts, and the captains, you know what I'm saying? The rulers and their hedging places. But when that sun comes and shines, bro, they're going to try to swim deep into the ocean, go into the clouds, like Amos 9 talks about.
God.
But those men, the elect, speaking as the hopeful elect, Lord, when we those men, we're going to get their asses, man. And it's a little more to it. A little more to it. Unless you had a point.
No, go ahead. Go ahead, brother.
It says, and their places is not known where they are. Thy shepherds slumber, O king of Assyria.
Mm.
Thy nobles shall dwell in the dust. Now, again, that links right back to Genesis, right after that serpent. Because remember, when that serpent did what he did, not only did Adam and Eve get judged for it, but the serpent said, the Lord said, look, hey, man, we're going to cut your legs off.
Yeah,
you're going to eat up the dust of the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And then thy shall bruise his heel, but he going to bruise your head. So he's going to destroy you. You know?
That's beautiful.
There's a little more to it, because it's the end of the chapter. It says, thy people are scattered upon the mountains, and no man gathereth them. All right, that was those mountains. They're going to flee.
They're
going to try to get it, but hey, heaven's knowing. This last verse seals it. There is no healing of thy bruise.
Ooh.
Thy head, remember, they shall bruise his head. You can't, if somebody hits you with a bat upon your head with all they might, you retard. If you don't die, you retarded or you a vegetable. There's no healing from it, man.
Ain't no healing.
You can get healed from
you. You just said in the 4th chapter of Malachi, the Lord is healing in his wings for the ones who believe,
that's
man.
That's right. That's
so,
right.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Straight up. It says, thy wound is grievous.
Grievous,
man. If somebody tears your Achilles heel, it takes time, but you can heal from it. It takes a lot of rest. Yeah. It takes you to kind of crouch down, like that crouching lion. It's going to take some time,
mm-hmm.
but you're going to heal. You know, that's why you read it in Genesis 3rd chapter. It says, and as he's talking to the serpent, he's saying, it, which is pertaining to the seed of the woman, which is Israel. It shall bruise thy head. And he says, thy, which is the serpent. Now he's talking to the serpent. Thy shall bruise his heel. But we read in Nahum, the 3rd chapter, that your wound is going to be grievous. And we're seeing the coming of it, man. We're seeing it in all aspects. It says, all that hear the bruit of thee shall clap hands over thee. For upon whom have not thy wickedness passed continually?
Mm.
So he's going to be, look at all he's built up. It's going to be continual until it gets burnt up.
Until it gets burnt up. And they continue to build.
Yep,
like they're going to live forever.
Exactly.
Psalms 49.
Going to live forever?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, man. So, hey, we just bringing scriptures to light, man, trying to, you know, through the Spirit, probably Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. You know, understand these scriptures. That's what it's about, reading and understanding what we read, because a lot of people do not have that gift. The
right.
Lord didn't give them that gift, man.
That's right.
So that's why he says 2/3 are going to be destroyed.
That's right.
You know, so, hey, man, we just doing our part in helping of the bringing down of this wicked kingdom, America.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to give all honor and glory and praise to the Heavenly Father and His Son, Yahweh,
Ba'ashim,
Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashim, Rakakodash. Double honors to our apostles, the elders, the GMS who rule well, and peace and blessings to the hopeful elect. This is Preacher Cal, Preacher R.
Shalom.
This is GMS Stop and Listen, and GMS Judgment
is here.
Is here.
That's right.
Hey, till next time, Shalom.
Shalom.